Hello there. My name is Dr. Anton Jessup, curator of monster studies here at the university. Now, I see you found your way into the university basement without any problem and, frankly, without any permission. But I must ask you not to touch anything down here because there are so many specimens that would love nothing more than to touch you back. Such as this little beauty right over here. I keep it sequestered away in a little glass jar, cut off from the rest of the world that it would so ruthlessly devour. It's a cosmic traveler, you see, and it goes by many names. Shoggoth, ooze, or simply, the blob. The first recorded blob encounter occurred back in 1958 when a small meteorite crash landed just outside Phoenixville, Pennsylvania. The first victim? A hobo, who like many of America's rail-riding rag sages, served as the self-appointed guardian of a local teenage makeout point. And amazingly enough, the exact same scenario repeated itself 30 years later in California. This small glob of star jelly first consumed the hobo's hand, then his arm, and finally it devoured his entire body. Glutting itself on a diet of sleepy-eyed townsfolk, the blob soon grew to immense size, squeezing through even the smallest cracks to spring itself on unsuspecting prey. But finally, emergency responders figured out the best course of action, to freeze the creature solid and ship it to one of the Earth's frigid poles, where, of course, other frozen things await the thaw of global warming. The blob is, of course, an unnatural creature, its strange origins lost to us in the mysteries of the outer dark. And yet, when we turn to the natural world, we find unmistakable examples of its monstrous biology. The blob most resembles a giant amoeba, the shapeless single-cell protozoa from your elementary science textbook that eats its prey by enveloping it with its cell membrane, a process known as phagocytosis. But exactly how big can a single cell get? In 2008, marine biologists in the Bahamas discovered giant seafloor amoebas the size of grapes. The creatures rolled through the sand, leaving behind visible trails that match up closely with 530 million-year-old fossils. But what happens when legions of single-cell amorphous creatures combine into a single monstrosity? Well, you might just get a full-blown blob, a 40-foot colony of genetically identical social amoeba, like those observed in a Texan cow pasture in 2009, and earlier still in the 1940s beneath a New York park. Such amoeba aggregations can even form migrating slug and fruiting body forms when it suits their purpose. These billion-strong slime conventions eat neither cattle nor New Yorker, but Harvard University evolutionary biologist Kevin Foster believes the amoebas raise, quote, the possibility that cells might evolve to organize on much larger spatial scales. Life is beautiful, isn't it? And really, what is this but life at its most basic? Self-replicating DNA, an absorption of nutrients, all in an endless evolutionary march to oblivion. Why? There are worse ways to go, my friend. End transmission.